I'm a landscape architect, and a lot of people just don't even know what landscape architecture is. They think it's something to do with bushes or adding planting to a project. But that would be like saying architecture is about bricks and adding glass to a project.
Landscape architects have always been sort of defined as, maybe self-defined as generalists. If we have a specialty, it's that we're generalists and we deal with a lot of different things.
There's so much we have to know about everything from civil engineering, botany, and horticulture, and architecture, and urban planning, and security design.
We have been thought of at times as horticulturalists. And yes, we do know a lot about plants, but it isn't the only thing or even the most important thing that we can do. It's one of our tools. It's one of the things with which we shape space.
But just like in architecture, we do a lot more. And it is structural. It has to do with the arrangement of parts. It has to do with resource management. It has to do with the use of materials. It also has to do with making places for people.
Landscape is this incredibly rich palette of materials and systems, and I think it really asks of us to go beyond the visual and to look at how we smell things, how we touch things, and how those experiences shape our understanding of space.
You're dealing with people's emotional responses to place as much as you're dealing with their physical responses to place. That comes with experience, that comes with modeling, that comes with watching people, that comes with paying attention to our environments. That's why we're landscape architects. We love it.
Identity is a key word. Identity is just not the appearance and how you experience it, but also the identity of the people that actually occupy and use the site. A public space, a park, a garden is for people. You have to place yourself on the level of a user and figure out what it is that they relate to.
It really is the planning of space for human use, which includes buildings, roads, ponds, canals, that sort of thing. That's landscape architecture. We're a branch of a big spectrum of human activity that goes from designing small objects to planning regions. And we tend to work at the site scale quite often, but often work larger than that.
Planners look at large-scale urban strategy. Urban designers look at urban form. Architects certainly look at the scale of a building or urban territory and detail, but landscape architects are doing that simultaneously. I don't think there's another profession that does that.
When people approach a landscape, they're seeing a bigger picture. They're coming from a context. They're seeing a place that they're arriving at, and it's part of something larger. But then they're occupying it at a very human scale. They're sitting on this bench, and they're in the shade, or they're not. And they're in noise, or they're not. So it's important to think about all those scales, and I think that's one of the things that's unique about landscape architecture. I think that's what we bring to the table.
I think it's terribly important for the landscape architect not only to be an integral part of the team, but be involved from the very get-go, before the building hits the ground.
And I think when you look at an architectural project where it began with the site, you can feel it. You feel that there's a difference in the way that it's connected to its place. It's not, oh, we need a park with benches, some shade, and some sculpture. Rather, this is actually an integral part of a living system connected to this building and the city. So it becomes a sort of insurance for the preservation of these landscapes. It's actually stitched to the site, and it becomes the connective tissue of building and civic realm.
Interestingly enough, as landscape architects, we're very interested in cities. And the reason is because that's where most of the people are. One of the things we realized a few years ago is that many people think cities and nature are antithetical. They think they're different, but they forget that cities are part of nature. We're in nature all the time.
In my perspective, landscape architects are no longer kind of defending nature from humanity, that there is a understanding that everything is interwoven. The whole world, in a sense, is a landscape.
It's just so much more than thinking just about that little boundary of the property line. it really needs to be connected so that it can live and thrive and inspire on a daily basis.
The challenge of the everyday is that you have to keep it interesting for somebody who goes there 700 times a year. Because I think the danger of landscape is that people stop seeing it. That's why they don't realize that it's everywhere. And what I try to do in my work is to make it so that through the seasons, through the sculptural transformations, from night to day, from season to season, you see something new. And you are rewarded for being there 900, 1,000 times a year.